All right, YouTube, this your boy Trucker Will. We're trucking it like always, trying to make this money, trying to make this dough. And in this video, guys, we're going to talk about what PSD students should not do unless you have a crazy bad behind PSD trainer. We're going to talk about it next on Trucking with Trucker Will.
Since the crack of dawn, just trying to get paid. Been hotter than 100 suns, I can't find no shade. Just 2 more rows and I'm good to go. Yeah, I'm shutting this tractor down. Give me a half an hour for a shave and a shower, and I'll be outside your house. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but I'm taking you uptown tonight. Might have a little mud on my wheels, but they gonna shine with you up inside. Gonna hit the club, gonna cut a rug, burn it up like neon lights. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but we're gonna dance the dust right off them tonight. Yeah, got a little dirt on my boots. Hard as I worked all day, I'm gonna work harder loving on you. Spin you all over that dance floor, right out of them high heel shoes. And when you're ready to quit, baby, we can slip right out of that barroom door. And when I take you home, don't worry, babe, I'm gonna kick them off on the porch. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but I'm taking you uptown tonight. Might have a little mud on my wheels, but they gonna shine with you up inside. Gonna hit the club, gonna cut a rug, burn it up like neon lights. Might have a little dirt on my boots, but we're gonna dance the dust right off them tonight.
Alright, YouTube, so we back, right? So, one of my buddies, he decided he was going to go trainer. And Lord knows, out here in the trucking world, it is not easy deciding to put another human being on your truck in your physical space. Unless you're a family member or real close friends, or that person lives with you, lives in your household. It's really kind of hard, right? So, when drivers decide, you know, and their fleet managers get with them and say, hey, would you want to be a trainer? There's a lot that goes into that. It's not just about the money, but it's about the psychological, you know, stress and thought process that goes into it. It's not just like, yeah, I'm gonna go be a trainer. Like when I was at England, it was almost a requirement. Like the only way you was gonna make money is if you go train. So like they force you into that because they incentivize you to make more money because you're not making any money soloing. This is back almost 2-3 years ago, but anyway. So one is that, you know, the trainer has to get his mindset ready to be able to train a PSD student. Now at Prime, it involves going through pre-trip, post-trip, and backing and your maneuvers and things of that nature. And then they take you out on the road to get comfortable driving, to get comfortable feeling how the truck moves and things of that nature, how to make your turns, things to look for, watching your mirrors, things of that nature. It's not just sitting in the seat and being like, okay, drive, you know, it's not all of that. So in this specific instance, a buddy of mine decided that he was gonna go trainer, and he went to Springfield and got his student after he did his class, and proceeded to work with this student for a long period of time. Now, for truck drivers, a long period of time is, you know, 6 days, a week, 2 weeks, whatever, you know, giving time to that student to help him be prepared to get out here on the road and get into his own truck and be able to be successful and take his family to the next echelon of success. So he had the student for 6 days, took him out, helping him, training him. And the funny part about this is me and this guy that he was that was the trainer, me and him have known each other for quite a long time. We, you know, pretty much started our trucking career together. So he was with the guy for 6 days, and he was struggling, you know. And I even called the guy and was like, yo, you know, try to give him some much added support, you know, that he's not out here by himself. He's got people that, you know, want him to succeed, want him to be successful in what he's doing. And, you know, just to kind of reinforce that positivity, that positive energy, that, like, man, you know, you got this, you know, give him some much needed help. You know, that's me. I'm all about helping anybody and anybody that wants to get to another level. And if I don't know, I'm going to find somebody that knows so I can give that information to make sure that everybody can out here and win. So, you know, we had a conversation, we had a dialogue, and I even said, yo, look, you're struggling. All right, bet. This is what I'm going to do. I'll give you $100. Set up a Cash App. I'll give you $100 when you pass. No worries. $100 cash free when you pass. Just to, you know, give you that, like, oh, you know, yeah. And I'm a man of my word. I'm a giver. I had it ready. So I was like, bruh, call me. When I was telling my buddy, call me when he passed, and I send it over. And me, we was having a conversation, and I could hear him in the back. He's like, man, I got this. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's like, you don't have to do this. It's not about me having to do anything. It's about me wanting to give you an extra value. You're not only going to get your license, but you're going to get $100, and you're not even somebody that I know. So, you know, I'm like, man, got this. So we got off the phone, a couple hours went by. He calls me and says, man, he failed. I'm like, what? I'm thinking he's joking with me. Like, he's like, no, bro, he failed. And I'm like, what? Like, what did he fail on? You know, I'm trying to figure out what's going on. Why is he failing? You know, I'm generally concerned because I want people out here to win. He's a young guy, you know, trying to get out here. And if you can start young, you can be financially set by the time you're 30. And he just had issues. But the thing that irked me a little bit was that my buddy had spent 6 days with him, 6 days down, not making any money. Now, this is where I say PSD students, don't do this. Don't be with a guy that's investing time, energy, you know, sacrificing to put money, to not necessarily money, but put time into you so that you can be successful. If he's not a bad trainer, and if he's generally there to make you a better driver and a better person out here on the road, and you up and just get off of his truck because your buddy decides that you want to go with his buddy, with your buddy, he's already invested, you know, 6 days with you. Now, as a lease operator, you don't really get paid all that much. You don't get paid as much as you would get paid running freight. You know, they compensate you, obviously, because you're down and you're doing a service for Prime, and you're providing a service to help another student get his license and get ready to get out here on the road for himself. But don't be that PSD student that jumps ship because it gets hard after another woman is spending time and energy and sacrificing to make you the better driver, to make you give you the insight that he has to help you get to the next level. Don't jump ship on him because he's already invested time and energy with you. And that's just not respectful. You know, that's downright like, dang, I don't care about you. I don't care about your sacrifice. I'm all about me. And I get it. It's all about, you know, yourself out here. But, you know, when those fleet managers come to us and ask us, hey, will you want to train? It's not only, you know, a benefit for us and our family, but it's also to benefit you and your family, because they come to us thinking that we're good enough to have something to be able to pass on to another driver in the next evolution of drivers that's coming down the pipe. So it was kind of jacked up how the guy did him. You know, I'm not going to say names or anything like that, but it's just kind of like, it was kind of jacked up, man. It you know, if you want to put it in numbers terms, my guy, he did, my buddy just, you know, lost out about maybe $6,000 worth of revenue that he could have been pulling loads, because he thought somebody was going to rock with him and he was going to train him, go from training to TNT. TNT did it, because how you look at it is that you sacrifice to train, to do PSD training. And then when you're doing PSD training, you're not running loads. So the sacrifice is that you're running, you're taking them out, showing them how to run the truck, how to run the business. And then from there, you go from PSD training to TNT training, and you try to keep the same TNT training because you've built a rapport, you've built a relationship with that student. But when things don't work out, when things go bad, and it's not because of the trainer, it's just because of the individual feels that he could do better with somebody else, and he doesn't communicate that, it looks bad on the student, but it also looks bad on everybody, because now it puts a bad taste in the driver's mouth. Like, man, they just gonna hop out, and I'm the one that's gonna take the loss or take the L, or the fact that was I bad? And then you gotta look at the fleet manager. The fleet manager, he had to ask you to do it, so then it makes him look like, dang, man. So then your fleet manager has to go around, you know, trying to find somebody to hop on your truck for you to help you run, because you've lost out on all that revenue. And then if you look at the circle of life here, if you're not making money, your fleet manager's not making money. So it's in his best interest to keep you rolling, to keep you happy, because at the end of the day, if I scratch your back, you scratch my back. But it just kind of was jacked up. But, you know, our fleet manager came through. He got him a student, TNT student, so he can get out here and rock out, make some money. But PSD students, if you get a good PSD trainer and he's not doing anything wrong, you're just struggling, stick it out. Stick with him, because he's not going to do you wrong. He's not going to do you dirty. So, I mean, I'm not all PSD trainers are, you know, the best, but majority of them are going to rock out with you. Make sure that you're successful. Make sure that you get them L's. Make sure that you get on the road, get into your own truck, and be the most successful driver that you can possibly be. Remember to be blessed, less stressed. Keep the left door closed, the right foot down, only when it's safe. Like always, guys, I will see you on the blacktop. Remember to like, subscribe, share, hit the bell below so you know when I come out with new videos. And I got some more driving footage of this year and last year kind of mixed into like one little jumbly. And then we'll come back and we'll chat a little bit more. All right, y'all.
Come on, everybody. Clap your hands. Oh, you're looking good. I'm going to sing my song. It won't take long. We're going to do the twist, and it goes like this. Come on, let's twist again. Like we did last summer. Yeah, let's twist again. Like we did last year. Do you remember when things were really? Thank you.
can hold us back. Nothing can tear us apart. Not life, not death, not the in-between. This is just the start. Don't let them keep you down. Don't let them push you out. We were made to live, to be fierce like lions. Love and forgive. Just keep moving on. Just keep pushing ahead. Yeah, the new has come. All the old is dead. Just keep moving on. Keep your eyes on the prize. And that word in your heart. Yeah, we'll be alright. We got that. We got that. We got that. Yeah, we'll be alright. Yeah, we're running out the darkness. Chasing down the dead of night. We're bringing hope to the streets. There's a new way, a better life. Only one can set the captive free. He's bringing sight back to the blind. Show the lame how to walk and make the dead alive. Just keep moving on. Just keep pushing ahead. Yeah, the new.